Today, we'll take a look at animating still images, graphics, and video clips in Final Cut Pro to make them less boring. First, let's take a look at animating still images. The easiest way to do this is by using the Ken Burns effect. You just add the still image to your timeline, select it, and from the Transform dropdown, select Crop and Ken Burns. You get two controls here, one for your start frame and one for your end frame. You can adjust the size of these, move them around, even swap the two, but that's about it. When you click Done and play back your clip, you move from your start frame to your end frame. Pretty basic, but there is a bit more we can do with this. For example, you can add more than one camera move to the same clip. Let's take the same clip as before, and with the Ken Burns effect applied to it, blade it in the middle. Select the second half, reverse the Ken Burns effect, make sure to leave the start frame as is, and change the end frame. Now we have two camera moves. If you want to add a pause in the middle, just place your playhead right on the cut and add a freeze frame with Option F. And to adjust the timing of any of these moves, just triple trim the clips. It's simple, but a super easy way to animate still images. Next, let's take a look at animating graphics. There's a few different ways to animate graphics to pop on and off screen. One of my favorites, and I don't see too many people using this method, is by using Final Cut Pro's built-in transitions. Let's have a scuba diver graphic pop on screen during our next clip. Add the graphic above your timeline and use the transform tool to adjust the size and location of it. Now, to animate it, go to your transitions browser and from the movements category, select the slide transition. Add this to the start and end of your clip. For the start animation, we'll leave it with the default setting sliding in from the right. And for the end animation, let's make it slide out. Set the direction to custom and use the on-screen controls to have it go up and to the right. Adjust the duration of each transition to set the animation speed. Add some sound effects for this cool graphic animation. While you can animate in Final Cut Pro, your options are fairly limited. If you're looking to add some complex, unique, or just some really cool looking animations, you may want to look at third-party plugins. Today's sponsor, MotionVFX, has a few amazing options. M-Movements, for example, lets you spice up your plain video clips with some really cool fake camera animations. You get presets for basic camera moves, cinematic moves, simulations, and more. M-Behavior Basic is a great free option that includes 90 essential animation presets, and I consider this a must-have for any Final Cut Pro user. If you want more, M-Behavior 2 comes with over 150 presets for flawless in, through, and out animations. All MotionVFX plugins are super simple to install and update with their M-Installer tool, and even more simple to use. You just add a preset above your footage, adjust a few parameters in the inspector window, and with just a few simple clicks, you get some amazing looking animations. Now, back to our video. The most versatile tool in Final Cut Pro for animation is the Transform tool. To animate a video clip, for example, place a playhead where you want the animation to start, select the Transform tool, adjust the framing of your clip, and add a keyframe. Move the playhead to where you want the animation to end, and use the Transform tool to reframe your clip. Since this parameter is already keyframed, as soon as you make any adjustments, another keyframe is automatically added. Up in the viewer window, you get a red line that represents the animation path, your keyframes, which can be set to linear or smooth by right-clicking on them, and if you select smooth, a set of Bezier handles to adjust the smoothness of the animation. We'll take a closer look at these in the next example. With these keyframes added, your clip will animate from the first keyframe to the next. You can add as many keyframes as you need to your clip for simple or complex animations. One thing you do need to keep in mind is while keyframing the position parameter allows you to choose between smooth and linear keyframes, the scale parameter does not. So if you keyframe the scale and position of your clip and set the position keyframes to smooth, since the scale keyframes will always be linear, you get a funky looking animation. The only way to fix this is by setting the position keyframes to linear. I really hope this gets fixed soon. Now, let's use keyframes in the transform parameter to make a camera whip transition. Zoom out on your viewer window so you have a bit of padding and set your playhead at the start of your first clip. Set the scale to about 120%, select the transform tool, and move your clip to the right. We're going to have the camera whip from right to left. Add a keyframe here. Move your playhead to the last frame of your first clip and move your clip all the way to the left. Hold down the Command key, grab the Bezier handle of your second keyframe, and drag it all the way over to your first keyframe. What this will do is make the animation start out really slow and exponentially speed it up at the end. Repeat the same steps for your second clip. Bring the scale up to 120% and keyframe moving in the same direction for continuity. This time, drag out the Bezier handle of the starting keyframe to have the whip at the start of this clip. To sell this effect, let's add some motion blur to our clips. Go to your effects browser, select the blurs category, and add the directional blur effect to both clips. Move your playhead about 10 frames before the cut, set the blur amount down to 0, and add a keyframe to the amount slider. Move to the last frame of this clip, and bring the amount up to about 100. Reverse these steps for the following clip, and add some sound effects for this cool camera whip transition. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about keyframing in Final Cut Pro, watch this video right here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.